Hello, everybody. I'm Matt Stryker here in Boyle Heights, Los Angeles, inside the Temple. It has been my honor and privilege to commentate for the hottest, freshest, coolest new show on television, Lucha Underground. For the uninitiated, this is everything you need to know about the world of Lucha Underground. For the returning believers, welcome back. Let's refresh your memory of the epic first year of Lucha Underground. Our story begins with this man.
Darío!
Lucha Underground's owner and promoter. While we don't know much about him, what we do know is that he's a wealthy promoter from Spain that opened the doors to the Lucha Temple here in Boyle Heights and invited the best fighters in the world to compete for honor and glory.
This is a temple, my temple, where we honor ancient traditions like courage, honor, and my personal favorite, violence.
Let's not forget my partner in crime, the living, breathing lucha legend, Vampiro.
I am Vampiro.
This has been a man who has been an integral part of the history of lucha libre wrestling and is making his own history right here in our temple. But more on that to come. Let's dive right in. We kicked off our first year by setting a high bar. Our first main event, Johnny Mundo versus Prince Puma. Prince Puma is a direct descendant from one of the seven Aztec tribes. And from everything we saw out of this fighter last year, Lucha Libre is in this warrior's blood. As for Mundo, he's a superstar in his own right. While he's been known by a few other names, here in the temple, he has embraced the Lucha Libre traditions and transformed himself into the one and only Johnny Mundo. Mundo and Puma teamed up against Cueto's enforcers, the Crew.
They work for me!
But nothing tears apart a friendship quicker than money.
You owe that money to Puma.
And the two trade punches back and forth.
Okay, I'm gonna hang up this money from the rafters of my roof because we're having a ladder match!
Lucha Underground's first ladder match was absolutely incredible. Johnny Mundo won the $100,000 prize. But Prince Puma ended up with Aztec Gold and became Lucha Underground's first champion after he bested Johnny Mundo and Mil Muertes in Dario Cueto's personal event.
Aztec Warfare! We start with two men. Every 90 seconds, another luchador enters.
Although Mundo celebrated with Puma, Johnny's ego would get the best of him, and Mundo became desperate to prove that he was the best. Mundo was given the opportunity to fight Alberto El Patron to be the number one contender. But Johnny miscalculated Patron's ability and lost out on that opportunity. And the loss ate at Johnny Mundo. Thus, Johnny did the only thing he could, prevent Patron from getting the glory that always seemed just out of reach. This was all happening while Prince Puma was defending his championship time and time again. Meanwhile, the dark and mysterious Mil Muertes continued to grow in strength and depravity. The once dead, now stronger than ever, man of a thousand deaths, our current Lucha Underground champion. And behind this great man, a great woman. The seductive Katrina and the mysterious stone she uses to control Mil and her disciples of death. The mere sight of Mil Muertes and his allies strikes fear through countless luchadors, except for one. From Mexico City, Mexico, Phoenix. In a truly epic casket match, Phoenix vanquished this man of a thousand deaths and quickly set his sights on the then Lucha Underground champion, Prince Puma. However, one man stood in his way, if you could call him a man at all. Drago, from Inframundo, the underworld, the man with the soul of a dragon. After losing to Prince Puma for the Lucha Underground Championship, Drago was banished from the temple.
We will meet again.
But won the opportunity to come back and fight Mil Muertes to be the number one contender. But Mil and Katrina were not about to let Drago take a shot at the Lucha Underground Championship away from their cold, dark hands. Dario, not satisfied with only having one championship for his luchadors to fight over, created two more. The gift of the gods pitted the entire temple against each other.
Earning one of these medallions will give you immortality.
while the Lucha Underground Trios Championship forced some of the teams to work together for Dario's own amusement. Enter the world's most unlikely and dysfunctional trios team. From the open road, Son of Havoc, the self-proclaimed baddest bitch in the building, Ivelisse. And all the way from South Africa, the breathtaking, awe-inspiring Angelico. Against all odds, with an injured Ivelisse and some truly dirty tricks from Dario Cueto, these three managed to capture Trio's gold. All of the darkness, destruction, and violence in the temple began to take its toll on my friend Ian, and he was finally confronted with a choice. Stand by or take action. Ladies and gentlemen, Pentagon Jr. Pentagon came to us from Mexico and quickly made a name for himself by threatening to make sacrifices for an unknown master.
He conseguido un sacrificio más para ti, mi amo.
These sacrifices came in the form of broken arms of countless victims. This violence slowly took its toll on Ian until Pentagon crossed the line. He attacked our announcer, Melissa Santos, and Ian decided he had had enough. But before he could act, Sexy Star swept in, putting herself in danger of a broken arm. Ian could no longer sit idly by. This man chose action. Pentagon retaliated and antagonized until the threats turned deadly.
Pentagon Jr., he's pushing and pushing me to do one more match. Ian Hodgkinson is not the guy who you're gonna face, because the guy who is gonna kick your ass is Vampiro!
And Ian became Vampiro once again. The divine winds blew, the stars were aligned, the warriors were ready for Dario Cueto's most brilliant and violent concept yet, Ultima Lucha. Johnny used dirty tricks to beat Patron with the help of an old friend. Vampiro pulled out all the stops against Pentagon Jr. and then revealed that he was Pentagon's master all along.
You are ready, my son.
I haven't seen him since. The mental and physical toll was enough to put any man away. I certainly hope my friend is okay. Phoenix rose from the ashes to claim the Gift of the Gods championship over powerful competitors such as Sexy Star, Jack Evans, and King Cuerno. Mil Muertes destroyed Prince Puma to capture the Lucha Underground championship, and the Disciples of Death took advantage of their 3-2 handicap to steal the Lucha Underground Trios championship. Death has come over the temple. Many fled the temple, including Dario Cueto and whatever dark secrets he may hold. And so, we begin our second chapter in the epic struggle of honor, violence, and glory. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Lucha Underground.